תודה רבה לאדוני מחשיב סודתי אלוהי יותח בו כי הוא ישינך על פח יקוש ודרך אבות יעסך לך תודה רבה לילה נחסי אוף ימם בקטר יסי שחסור וסיר רבה לך חבי שלי יסבל לך נשמע הכפיים ואינסן אוכה פן תגוב באבן רגליך שחר לפתן תדרוס כמור כי וחשק אפלתה וסגבה
היקר ששמענו עליו הרבה דברים טובים מאיר קארי שהגיע מארצות הברית לקבורה בארץ מבקש מכבוד הרב הרב יוסף בכבוד לדברי הסבב
מיקי was an angel המלאך that הקדוש ברוך הוא sent to the community. He represented what we wanted to be, what we couldn't be. He represented the best of our community. He taught our children to read the Torah. There is nothing more important than to read the Torah with Tamim. And he dedicated his life to teach our children how to get Olam Abba ba'olam hazeh. Because when you read the Torah with ta'amim, you're hearing the voice of Borei Olam. It's not pure intellect. Ta'amim is from the heart. And he taught our children also how to sing the songs of joy. Torah makes us happy to be religious. A religious Jew is to be a happy Jew. To be a religious Jew means to sing Pizmonim, to sing the songs of our father. And he also, in his own way, he taught how to be a Jew from within. I don't remember Mickey Carey walking with kippah in the street. I don't remember Mickey Carey showing how religious he was. The religion of Israel, Bechol Levavecha, you have to worship Borei Olam with all your heart. And he worshiped Borei Olam with all his heart. Now, everybody, I cried out also. But he's going to meet Eshet Chayil. He's going to meet Pat. That was a match made in heaven. The Sirakot that Pat made, not only with money, with Achnasat Orchim. I remember when I used to come to their house and have the meal made by Pat. Special hamburger. I never ate hamburgers like that in my life. All right? I never. Hans used to be not only a great cook, but a superb host. You come to her house and you see Mickey and Pat happy. You think that you have a Shekhinah in front of you. Yes? You think that the Shekhinah is in front. And I want to say something that I love by the band. I love Mickey. And you know what? You cannot, the Goyim, they have statues and this and that, this. But we discovered Borei Olam in a Beit HaKnesset. There's nothing in the Beit HaKnesset, you know, four walls. Sometimes, great men and women, you cannot see that they are superior people.
You have to feed them. You have to be with them. You have to hear their voice. I have to tell you a story about Mickey. First time I see him, in the 1950s, 1954 maybe, 1955, something. I was a young man, and I used to love Talmud. I used to love Talmud. I was a young man. And Mickey came, comes, and he had the upper part of the uniform. He didn't have a whole uniform. He's from the army. He was in the army. And it was regular pants, but he had the jacket, the army jacket. And I don't know if you remember this. I started talking to him, and he did not Talmud. You know, Mishnayot. No Shulchan Aruch. No for yourself. And it was like a boat without an anchor. And we start talking, and I discovered that he knows Tahamim. I said, Mickey, you know Tahamim. Your mission is to teach Tahamim. You have no Tahamim. Seriha, you don't have the lower floor. It's very, very difficult to climb to the upper floor. You teach Tahamim. And he said, but this, no. Teach Tahamim. And he taught Tahamim. You know what the word Tahamim means? Flavor, taste. Yes? Flavor, taste. And if you study, read the Torah with Tahamim, you discover a special flavor to the Torah. It's true. Yes. What we love our mother's cooking, correct? We all love our mother. Because the cooking of our mother was the Tahamim, the culinary Tahamim, that shaped our taste. The Tahamim of the Torah shaped our neshama. The neshama of the children is not made through philosophy of Judaism, through other days. It's made the children, they know how to hear. The ear, Shema Israel, Shema. And he knew Tahamim. And when people that studied the Tahamim, my son, studied Tahamim with him, all right? They had the flavor of it. I want to finish with a confession. I was a young man. Baruch Hashem, Gam Zakanti. Velo ra'iti, an individual that loves the Torah so much, like Mickey Carey. We'll miss you, Mickey. We'll miss you. We love you, Mickey. You taught all of us. I'm Chacham, but I learned from you. Anava. Anava. Love to the other Jews. Love to teach Torah. We're going to miss you. So I'm going to ask you a favor, Mickey. Protect us. Whenever it's time for anyone, something, you protect us. You together. Oh! With my friend, Eliyahu ibn Najed. All right? And Jack, Arama. All right? You protect us. We'll miss you very, very, very much.
יום המוות ויום עם הולדו. מיקי ליווה את כל הקהילה מיום שנולדו עד יום שמתו. ברית מילה מיקי. פדיון הבן מיקי. בר מצווה מיקי. חתונה מיקי. לוויה מיקי. אני זוכר, הייתי בניו יורק, הוא היה בפלורידה. היה צריך לתאר איזה מישהו, הוא נסע מפלורידה לניו יורק,
עשה לו טהרה, הוא חזר לפלורידה. כל החיים שלו היה צנוע, קטן, ענב, היה יותר גדול מכולם. יותר גדול מכל החכמים. היה לו דעה ישרה. 50 שנה טיפל בכל הקהילה. אין אחד בעולם. יותר מ-50 שנה. זה לא יאומן, אין דברים כאלה. לך יואם הזהב ישנה הכתם הטוב. כשמגיע בן אדם למעלה, איך הקדוש ברוך הוא רואה אותו? אם יודעים זהב, איך יודעים אם זהב אמיתי או משקר? אם הזהב מקבל שחור, סימן שהוא זהב אמת. כי זהב אף פעם מלוכלך, לא מלוכלך, זה שקר. מיקי מסכן, היה לו הרבה היסטורים בסוף. אני זוכר, היינו לפני כמה שנים פה במקום, בלוויה של אשתו. היה בוכה, אמר לי, זהו. עכשיו עוד מעט אני הולך אליה. ומאז גמרנו, יותר לא קם. מתי שרואים אותו היה שבור, שנים היה שבור, היה לו איסורים האחרונים כדי לעלות למעלה לקדוש ברוך הוא זך. הקדוש ברוך הוא עכשיו שמח לקבל אותו. זה האנשים הבודדים שהיו לקהילות מאז הרבה דורות. מיקי, הם מבקשים ממך, אתה עכשיו עולה למעלה. תבקש מהקדוש ברוך הוא על עם ישראל, על יושבי ארץ ישראל, מפחדים לצאת החוצה מרוב מחבלים, מרוב איסורים, על חיילי הצבא שהשם ישמור אותם, על כל עם ישראל שיבוא משיח ויגאל אותנו. מחילה, 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 סליחה, סליחה.
יש מחילה וסליחתו, אנחנו מבקשים סליחה ממך, אם חטאנו, עבינו, פגענו, אנחנו מבקשים את סליחתך, ותהיה מליץ טוב לכל הקהילה, אמן, לכל עם ישראל.
אמן.
There's a story in the Gemara that Hashem was a little upset at Moshe Rabbeinu. Moshe Rabbeinu comes to Egypt, he's going to be the savior, and it doesn't work out. Paro makes things harder, so Moshe Rabbeinu gets upset and he says, what happened? You sent me and now things are worse. He's complaining. Hashem tells Moshe Rabbeinu, Haval al de'avim ve'la mishtakehin. He says, listen, I feel bad. Hashem's telling Moshe Rabbeinu, I feel bad. What does he feel bad for? I remember people like Abraham, Yitzhak, and Yaakov, they had emunah. They never complained. Moshe Rabbeinu was the greatest ever, by the way. Nobody higher than Moshe Rabbeinu. But Hashem is remembering the people who never complained, who had emunah. Haval al de'abdim v'la mishtakehin. I never met a person like Mickey, who every person, he saw the good in that person. I was privileged to be a rabbi in Magen David. I'm a little young punk. I was a rabbi in a synagogue, you understand this? A guy would come in, Israeli, Mechalel Shabbat, people, what the hell? He says, Mickey, what are you talking about? He has a talet. Does he have a talet? You're doing a mitzvah. A guy, a Kohen, wasn't so, supposedly not so religious. He'd go up to say Kohanim. Mickey says, what a beautiful voice. I want this guy to stay. What a beautiful voice. Anytime somebody had something bad to say about something, Mickey said, no, this guy is beautiful. This person is, amen. This was Mickey. He never complained. He was like Abraham, Yitzhak, and Yaakov. Haval al de'abdin v'la mishtakehin. But it wasn't just that. He saw beauty where other people couldn't see beauty. I used to sit with him after Seudat Shilishi before Arvit Mosai Shabbat. He take out a simple song. He say, Avi, look at this tizmon. A simple Nase'im ad ha'olam. A simple song. He said, Avi, imagine this. Imagine a symphony. Imagine you have the whole symphony doing the song. You know how beautiful that is? He'd see beauty where nobody else would see beauty. He'd see beauty in people. He'd see beauty in Pizmonim. He'd see beauty in the world. When his spiritual mentor, Yaakov Aram, Alav Hashalom, a great Sadiq, he was suffering. He was suffering before he died. Mickey told me, he asked Yaakov Arama, why he's suffering? And I'll always remember this. Yaakov Arama told this to Mickey, and Mickey told this to me, and he said, remember this. That's between me and Hashem. If I'm suffering, Yaakov Arama, that's between me and Hashem. It's none of your business. And Mickey's message was, don't complain about Hashem. There's things in the world, anava. We don't have to understand everything. You know, today we think we have to understand everything. Mickey taught us, you don't have to understand everything. It's okay. We can love Hashem. with all our hearts. We can love the world. We can love people and not understand. That's Mickey. I want to end with the following. My father mentioned what Abba mentioned to Amim. There's a lot of good readers. Okay. Delina, remind me. There's a lot of good people who read the Torah. And there's a lot of books on reading. I want to tell you something. I read the Torah in his face. What he taught me personally, and I thought I was a good reader. Okay. What he taught me, I'll never read in 100 years in books. I'm telling you. When you read a pasuk, he says the last letter in the pasuk, you're skipping it. Everybody skips it. You don't skip a letter. He says Aharon. It's not Aharon, it's Aharon. Every Aharon in the Torah is Aharon. It always has a ma'amid. I teach my boys ta'amim. In Eretz Yisrael, and I'm saying it's Israel, Mickey, this is Eretz Yisrael. This is where the Shekhinah is. I don't think there's a shiur, but I'm studying with my boys, and we're studying ta'amim. Boys, you know what I'm teaching you now? I'm teaching you something you'll never learn anyplace else. You know where it comes from? It comes from Mickey. And that's the emet. It comes from Mickey. I want to end with the following thought. And then he asked me to see if he's one for him. So I will. I was sitting down Friday morning. We had a separate Torah in the house. My grandfather, by the way, met Mickey, and they loved each other. You know the story with Avraham Avinu meeting the Malachim? That's like Mickey meeting my grandfather in Haifa. Okay, so we have a Sefer Torah in the house. My son is reading the Torah in the nets. And my other son, so he's practicing on the Sefer Torah. And my other son is sitting there giving him signs. And I start thinking about Mickey. I mean this. I start thinking about Mickey. I didn't know that he passed away. And I'm saying, you know, if Mickey saw this, he would be so happy. Because these are his Talmidim. They're his Talmidim. They're sitting here in Eretz Yisrael reading the Torah beautifully. His Talmidim. And I said, you know, I took out my phone, never did this before, for this particular thing. I said, I want to tape my son. My son doesn't like me taping him. I don't care, I'm taking out the phone. I want to send this to Mickey. I want Mickey to see this so he understands what's happening here in Israel because of him. So when I heard he passed away, I was really sad. But then I thought about it. I said, no. I made a mistake. You see, when somebody dies, Hashem takes the neshama and he shows him, you see this? This is because of you. You see this? This is because of you. I don't know what Hashem showed Mickey that day. He probably showed him thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of things. Good things in this world that are because of him. And I'm pretty sure that the reason I felt Mickey was because Mickey was there and Hashem was showing him, look at the Sefer Torah. Look at these boys reading the Torah together. This is you, Mickey. They're in Eretz Yisrael. These are the seeds that you planted in the world. You asked me to sing a song. I'll sing a song. It was that simple song that we were doing, before Arvit and Shabbat. You know that, right? I have this recording. I don't now. Okay. And thank you, Mickey. And by the way, I just want to say just one thing. There was one Sardash Shavishit on Shabbat in Beit Olam a few years ago. And this just shows you what an on-off person this was. It's like I'm sitting there, people ask me questions, the Shailot, Halachot, and this. And I suddenly see Mickey standing there. Like, I don't understand why he's standing. I didn't understand. And I have to apologize because he was standing. He wanted to ask me a question. You understand, Anava, this guy? He's standing up. He's not like interrupting. He doesn't say, excuse me. No, he's just standing there. And suddenly I'm looking at Mickey, and Mickey, I apologize. I didn't realize. Is this a person who doesn't have to stand up to ask this question? There's a person that doesn't have to if you're the really best person, best to go. Chaval al de'avdin, be'emet chaval al de'avdin v'lam chayam. What one to us that we lost such a great person like Mickey? All I can say is we should really try to, you know, take what we learned from him and build it around us. Nase'em ad ha'olam, chevra Yisrael kulam, uvden ale nafsham, בתוך מהלך לכל נעד אמן יתחת חשקו על המעט האחת סמוך נעד אמן יבחר חשקו על המעט האחת ימינך תאיר אורם בהרפיים סירם ומיזיים פלם קטנם עם גדולם. Sorry, Mickey, I know I messed that up and I don't make mistakes in the world, in the word. That's the best I can do. That's what I gave you. I love you. We'll do it again at Shabbat.
Mickey, we go back since 1960. And who was the one that could make everybody happy? Who was the one that at any time when he saw anybody sad, he had a joke, an appropriate joke, sometimes not so appropriate, but he had an appropriate joke for that moment to make everybody laugh. The sorrow didn't find him in any way. Mickey was always there for the person who was miduke, for the person who was hurting, for the person who didn't have what to live for the person that didn't have what to see right. Young and old were all the same. Young and old were there for him to make happy. And everybody needs to smile. Mickey never allowed anybody not to smile. In the hardest situations, he went, and the Baal Tshuva movement, coming back to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he was one of the beginners with a Chamfa'ur that started the whole revolution in the community. There was a revolution that started 60 years ago. In 1959, 1960, and who brought that, who did that? He was one of the people that were strongly behind it and stayed strong until this day. Mickey, you have the zchuyot of what the Hacham said and what the Avraham and the other Hacham, Arav Shrem, it's all true. Why? Because you were there for everybody. Now, Baruch Hashem, we are zocher to be here for you. Hashem Natan, Hashem Lakah. Yishem Adonai Mevorach Me'atah Ve'ad. Amen.
You are paying our last respects to a giant of a man. The most beloved and revered individual in our community, reverence which has spanned a number of generations, shared by all young and old, rich and poor, scholar and layman, a man so gentle, so kind, so generous, so dedicated, so funny. He was a man that was so humble that when he marveled at the beautiful development of our community, he failed to realize that he was the primary reason for their accomplishments. Meir Mickey Carey Ben Latife, Zecher Tzadik Livracha, together with his wife Pat, Aleha Shalom, after she passed away, he was a shell of his former self. Together they embodied every value of our Torah, of our unique heritage. Mickey was a gift, a treasure that Borei Olam gave to our community and put in our life. We remember him when we were kids, even before we went to school, one used to come in and collect the report, takes his shoes off in the entrance and make sure he leaves 18 cents in the coupon before he leaves. And he studied this morning even the thing in David where they had taught thousands and thousands of kids. The link. When state. Until then, one of the stories, everybody left Ocean Park where he stayed. Can you imagine 50 years after the community leaves the Ocean Park where he's taking care of the kids? The kid is at Hata Seba Park, and the kids are at the right. Taking care of the kids day in and day out. You don't need fuss. There's so many traits that Tony can speak about to make you do the last one. You want to hear it. But I didn't have to say a couple of small stories when he used to come to Israel in the summers. The tremendous brother there is Israel. Of course, part of his daily routine was to give to that court. But who did he give it to? I had the fortune of going once with him. He has the money in his pocket. And he walks and he walks and he walks and he looks for a street cleaner. He looks for an old, you know, cleaning the streets, and he just stick 100 shekel, 200 shekel in his pocket. He once, he went out to dinner, and there was, and he used to go out to eat, but we used to spend the weekends with him in Netanya. So he sees a waitress, a very young waitress, obviously she's new on the job. He gives her an exorbitant tip. I mean, something ridiculous. I said, okay, what are you doing? He said, she's starting out. Give her a break. I mean, give her a break. The hachamim he brought to life, and always the ones who were, not masakin, but the ones who, you know, they wouldn't get that kind of attention if it wasn't for Mickey. The hacham David Shama. And he brought to life us. We would know. Of course, the stories. Mickey, when he was young, he was old with wisdom. And when he was old, he was young in spirit. He spoke to the children, he spoke to the elderly, he spoke to everybody with the kindness he had. There's nobody like him. Nobody will be like him. We were blessed. I was blessed to have him as the best friend of my father-in-law, Alav Shalom. That is why I was able, after we were married, to spend almost every Sunday with him. To play stickball, or go out to Rackers. It was almost every Sunday. And it was Olam Umlo'o. He's a Kro Baruch.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. הוא יאיר גם בעולמות העליונים. יברו שהם מלמד הטעמים. הטעמים לא כתובים בתורה. האותיות יש להם דרגה, הנקודות דרגה אחרת שלא כתוב בטעמים, דרגה הכי גבוהה. זה אצילות. זה היה איש, אציל נפש. אתם הכרתם אותו בארצות הברית שנים. אני אקחת אותו מהארץ, שבא לחנות שלי ועושה לי מסאז'ים. גם עכשיו קשה לי לעמוד, אבל איך לא לעמוד? אני התקשר כזה, של כל חייו נתן לקהילה ולזולת. אלה הבנים שיש לו. הוא לוקח איתו את המצוות ומעשים טובים. כל שנה, גם לפני שמרת אשתו נפטרה, ואחרי זה יבל, הייתי מלווה אותו, שם אבנים, לא תאמינו, אבנים קטנות, דמות לב. אם תעלו לקבר, תראו אבנים כאלה על אבא שלו, על אחיו ועל אשתו. היה כולו נשמה. כולו לב טוב. למי לתת? היה עובר דרכי ללכת שיחיו לרב, לישיבה של רב עתיה. איך לחלק כסף, איך לתת לעניים. היינו לוקחים מונית, כמה עולה? נותן עוד 100. לא מכיר אותו, אבל זה הלב שלו. אני לא רוצה להריץ, דיברו פה דברים נפלאים. טהרת הנפטר, אני הייתי פעם עם חכם יוסף שלוש עליו השלום. אני יכול להגיד לכם את הדבר הכי קשה לאדם, לראות מת ולראות אותו. אבל אדם שעושה לשם שמיים, כמו שהוא עשה, זה חסד של אמת. אלה המצוות ילוו אותו, בדין של מעלה יזכו אותו ישר לגן עדן עליון, יחד עם אשתו יהיה להם שי עולמות ושי עולמות, ויהיה כתר על ראשם, וכל המצוות שעשו במחייהם, מה שלימדו ילדים, כל מה שהוא עשה, גם אשתו זכתה. ועכשיו מה שהוא הולך למעלה, הולך טהור ונקי בארץ הקודש, אשר כל כך אהב אותה. אספר לכם דבר קטן שהוא סיפר לי. אני הכרתי את בנת של הרב השלום בבית של חכם דוד לניאדו, לפני אולי 40-50 שנה. הייתי פוגש אותו שמה, וישר לנו. הוא היה מספר איך היה שותה את הערק בשבת, איך היו שותים עונך שבת, איך היו שרים. דבר אחד, אני מוכרח להגיד, הוא היה בקהילה של החלבים, וראש הקהילה והחלבים הרבה שנים היה עליו השלום יצחק שלום.
כן.
אינני זוכר בדיוק המילים, אבל הוא היה שר שיר, והיה אומר, כשנכנס יצחק שלום, היה אומר, הגיע הנדיב הגדול, יצחק שלום. הוא גם יקבל אותו לבעלה. בשמחה, שתלך מכאן בשמחה רבה, מצוות גדולות אתה לוקח, ואל תשכח להתפלל עבור כל אלה שמליוו אותך כאן, וכל אלה שהיו איתך כל ימי חייך, שיתפלל הקדוש ברוך הוא לפני הקדוש ברוך הוא, שהוא מדי לצרותינו, ויבוא משיח צדקנו, במחילה ויבאנו אמן.
אמן.
ונראה אותו בתחיית המתים.
אמן. אמן.
ממנו מחילה וסליחה וכפרה, ומחלים לו, מחול לו, מחול לו, מחול לו.
Worthy of being trying to speak salah like the kids and like that, but I want to share some things. I was not zocher in my young years to learn ta'amim by him, but over the years, Baruch Hashem, a decade dealing with kiruv in the community, and then when I moved here, and I spoke with him several times.